Okay. So, let's take a look at 1 negative 2 and see if we can get it changed into its record for 4 units. Okay. Now, first of all, if we're changing this into polar coordinates, what are we looking for? R and theta, and you're calling R magnitude, and that's absolutely fine. That's what it is. In the little unit we just did, that's the magnitude for that. So if you want to think of that as magnitude, that's great. So if we draw a picture of 1, negative 2, this is R. Envision a big circle. That is R. So what is R? 5. Theta is this angle. This is theta. But of course, you're not going to find that one. You're going to find this one first, right? And you're going to find that on your calculator by pressing what buttons? Second tangent 2. So that came out to be 63.43. So then how do you get your actual theta? So hopefully you got 296.57. Now, what question do we have about that? Okay, now there are a couple of little things we need to talk about. This is the answer. We're done. Okay. However, unlike rectangular coordinates, points in the polar plane can be named in many different ways. Here's what I mean. In the rectangular coordinate system, if I put a point right there, there is only one way to name that point. You would say that is the point 1, 2. And that's it. That's the only way. But in the polar plane, if I plotted a point, let's say this is the 45 line, if I plotted that point right there, one way to name that point would be 2, 45. Would you agree with that? But there are other ways to name that point. Can you think of one? What would be another way to name that very same point?
2.
Yeah? No? You are on the right track. Yeah. 2, negative 315?
Yep.
Where's negative 315? Isn't it in exactly the same spot as 45, just going the opposite direction?
Yeah.
Yeah. Would there be other ways besides those two to name that point?
Yeah.
Can you think of another one?
2, 405. I really got that one.
Couldn't you rename this point on any of the coterminal angles for 45 degrees? And how do we find coterminal angles? We either add 360 or we subtract 360. But it's even more exciting than that. Because when we start graphing some equations, and that will happen very soon, we are going to run into this very strange phenomenon of having a negative R value. Now, that sort of freaks us out because we think, wait a minute, how do you graph a negative distance? If the radius is negative, it means the point will actually be plotted 180 degrees different. We think of this as like the opposite. So if you think of a circle, if I'm out here in quadrant 1, where would you think the opposite of that would be? Quadrant 3, 180 degrees different. So when your radius is negative, you're actually plotting 180 degrees different. So this point actually is the same as this one. These are the exact same two points. They're plotted in exactly the same place. Because when I see a negative radius, it means, okay, don't plot it on 225. Plot it on the opposite of 225, which would be 45.
How do you get a negative radius?
Pardon me? How is that going to happen?
Yeah, if you multiply those two together, you should always get a positive. Or like you should...
No, you're right. What I said when we start graphing these, because we're going to have equations that look like r squared equals 9 sine 2 theta, for example.
Okay.
And we're going to graph that. And when we graph it, in order to graph it, we're going to take the square root of both sides. And what's going to happen? We're going to get plus or minus.
All right. Cool.
Okay. So let's talk about this again, because it's a pretty simple concept, but it gets a little confusing. So let's make sure we're clear on that.
That stuff is so ridiculous.
Let's suppose we have to find polar coordinates for the point negative 3, negative 2. And we're going to do two of them. We're going to have R positive, and we're going to have R negative. So we're going to do this twice, the same problem twice. We're going to do two answers. Now, when, like Stephen just said, he made an excellent point. When you convert this, R will come out positive. Because when you draw a picture of this, and you go down here like this, over 3, down 2, what are you going to tell me R is? Square root of 13. It automatically comes out positive. Now, in a minute, we'll manipulate it and make it negative. But when you do the problem, it's positive. Okay. What's the angle? Well, again, this is the angle that you want, but you're going to find this one first. So we can find that one, second tangent. So I got 33.69 for my reference angle there. So 213.69. Does anybody have a question about that? That's the initial step. That's what you did on your quiz. Madeline, you are not chewing gum again today, are you? Unbelievable. You're getting a detention for this one, and now we're going to start all over again. Or do you just want two detentions?
All strictly next one.
I've heard that before.
Like, you okay. Can at least hide it a little bit better. So
everybody's okay with this answer. Right? Now,
yeah.
I'm going to change the radius to a negative. I'm just going to say, okay, I've been asked to do that. R less than 0 means negative. I'm just going to make my radius negative. What does that do to my angle? It does not stay 213. It changes by 180 degrees, so it becomes 33.69.
Do you have to subtract 180?
You may add or subtract, depending on the size of the original. In this case, subtracting makes more sense because that keeps us less than 360. We could add, but that would make a big angle. Now, okay, good. Now we're going to go the other way.
Okay, Dave.
Oh, wait, just to make sure everybody's got it. Where would you plot this point? If you found this point and you had to plot it, where would you put it? You would not put it on 10 degrees.
3, 5, 3, 7, 190.
You'd put it on 3, 190. Remember, boys and girls, a negative radius means you plot the opposite point. So if this is 10 degrees, where's the opposite going to be? In quadrant 3, right? 180 degrees different. All right, let's try another one. I don't know. If you had to plot negative 4, 100, you would not plot it at 100 degrees. Where would you plot it? At 280. This would get plotted at 4, 280. negative radius means plot in the opposite quadrant. So instead of plotting in quadrant 2, you would plot in quadrant 4. 180 degrees opposite. Okay. All right, let's go the other direction. Let's change 3, 70 degrees into rectangular coordinates. Anybody remember the other name for rectangular coordinates?
Cartesian,
very good. So that could say change into Cartesian coordinates. Basically, this is r, this is theta, and what are we looking for? X and y. You just took a quiz, boys and girls. How do you find x? What does x equal?
Cosine.
X does not equal cosine. X equals r cosine theta. This is r, this is theta. Finding x and y is the simplest thing you're ever going to do. X equals r cosine theta. You type it in on your calculator and you get your x coordinate. 1.03. And then what does y equal?
3 sine theta,
or r sine theta. 3 sine 70. 2.82. Done. We'll do one more, even though these are so easy. Let's change 4, 3π/8 into rectangular coordinates. Okay, what does x equal? Always, always, always. X equals? Or x equals 4 cosine 3π/8. And y equals 4 sine 3π/8. Now, we can change that radian measure.
Speechless.
We can change that radian measure into a degree measure if we want. Or we can just change our calculator into radian mode. That's what I'm going to do. Now, what do you mean?
Like when we write our final report, we'll
your final answer has a few angles in it.
Yeah.
So 4 cosine 3π/8. 1.53 and 4 sine 3π/8. 3.70. Isn't that easy?
Yeah.
Easy as pi. Read or your hand up?
Easy as 3π/8.
Let's look then in our book on page 540. And we're going to do the same thing with some equations.
Big surprise.
It's like 8:15, 32 seconds.
Okay, what we've got here. Oh, I've just copied that total problem. This is on page 540, and I have copied down 36 and 42. And the directions say, change from this polar equation into a rectangular equation. Now, what does that mean? What does it mean to be a polar equation? It means your variables are r and theta. We want this to become a Cartesian equation So we want to get rid of the r's and thetas and have our equation have x's and y's in it, right? That's the goal. So I'm going to think back. Cosecant, I do not have a conversion formula for cosecant. So I'm going to think back to that picture I drew yesterday. And I keep this picture with me all the time because it just ties everything together so nicely. Looking at this picture, what's the cosecant of theta? What's the cosecant of theta? R over y. So r equals negative 2 r over y.
Huh.
Now, what might we do to that equation? It's not too good. What might we do with it? Get rid of the fraction? So what would that look like if we did that?
R times
R y equals negative 2r. Any thoughts on what you might do with that? You can divide by r. Now normally, I would be freaking out if somebody said divide by a variable, because that's one of the commandments of mathematics, one of the ten commandments, do not divide by a variable. However, it's okay in this case because I know r can't be zero. What happens if r is zero? Think about your polar coordinate plane. What happens if r is zero?
Zero, zero.
You're just at the pole, right? So we know that's not the case. So we're going to go ahead and divide by r. And what does this equation become? Y equals negative 2. Now, in a minute, we're going to get our calculators out. We're going to graph. And if we had graphed this equation, it would come out to look like this, which is what? What kind of equation is this? What does this look like? Well, it's a line, special line, though. No, it's not a vertical line. It's horizontal. It intersects the y-axis at negative 2. It's a horizontal line. All right, let's try this next one. Let's do the same thing we just did. What's cosine theta? Look at your picture. What's cosine theta? X over r. What's sine theta? Okay, so you see in both cases, I started by substituting for the trig function. Whatever the function is, I went ahead and put in the fraction. You know what it was. Cosine is x over r. Okay? Now, what do you think I might do here?
Can you cancel everything? Zero?
Multiply by r to clear the fraction. This was your quiz question. What's r squared? Now, keep in mind, gang, what are we supposed to be doing here? We started with this equation, and which is a polar equation, and what are we supposed to be doing with it?
Getting rid of the r
and theta, and creating an x and a y. Did we do that? This is now a rectangular equation, or a Cartesian equation, right? Now, what about the other direction? What if we started with rectangular? That would be something like number 46.
Wait, is that a new problem, or is that the same problem?
Number 46, what kind of an equation is that?
Linear.
Okay, it's a line, but in terms of being polar or rectangular, which kind is this?
Rectangular.
This is rectangular. We're going to make it polar. Okay, this is the other easiest thing you've ever done in your life. What does x equal? So your quiz question, what does x equal? So I'm going to take out the x, and I'm going to put in r cosine theta. And then guess what I'm going to do with the y? Put in r sine theta. Now, take a look at that equation. You might not like the looks of that equation, But what are its variables?
What are the variables in here?
R and theta, which means it is now a polar equation. And that was the job. Change this rectangular form into a polar form. Is that easy or what? All right, let's do a couple graphs. This will find interesting. So let's get our calculators out. Now, we need to go to mode. And remember the other day when we were graphing parametric equations? In mode, we went to parametric. Well, now, right next to parametric, you should see POL. And guess what that stands for?
Polar.
Let's do this in degrees. So let's have everybody in degrees, and everybody's in polar mode. So far, so good. All right, let's go to our window. So everybody is in polar mode, and everybody is in degree mode. Now, I went to my window, and it says theta min, theta max. I am in degrees, so what is your thought? 0 to 360, you are getting it. Now, for step, I want you to put 5. We're going to talk about that. But for now, just put 5. And for our x min and max, let's just leave it at negative 10 and 10. And the same for the y's. We may have to adjust that depending on what we graph.
I think that's 0 to 360.
Now, when you press y equals, like you're going to put in an equation, all of a sudden it doesn't say y equals now. What does it say?
R1 equals.
Because we are in polar mode, so we don't have x's and y's anymore. We have only r's and thetas.
I've got x minus negative 10, so whenever I try to go down to x max, change it, it says it's an error.
I don't know. I'll have to look at it. Okay, let's type in this equation. R equals 3 sine 5 theta. Type that equation in. Now, theta is your X button, your variable button. So you just type 3 sine 5 theta. Megan, what are you doing? Are you sick today? Okay. Kind of lounging and looking like you're...
Yeah.
3 sine 5 theta.
What?
Press graph.
Why does this devil work?
Now,
wow.
You should have gotten what we call a rose. This is called a rose.
Yeah, it's more like
a daisy. Now, I want you to, okay, look at it. Just take a good look at it. Then I want you to go back and I want you to change this 3 to an 8. And I want you to tell me what happens when you leave everything else the same, but change the 3 to an 8.
I think
bigger. Oh my goodness.
What happened?
I didn't get it.
It's a huge one.
Well, it's just bigger.
Yes, it's heavy. What?
Do you remember, girls?
Yeah, obviously you can't handle girls.
Do you remember at the beginning of the year when we graphed 2 sine x? It looked like this. It went up and down 2. And when we graphed 4 sine x, it went up and down 4. This number out here in front controlled how tall the curve was, right? In a circular system, what does this number out in front do? Control the size of the radius, right? How far out do the petals go? So, you would say this rose has petals that are 8 units long. The original was smaller, its petals were only 3 units long. Right?
Nope.
Now, let's change our equation. And let's go ahead and leave the 8, but let's graph cosine 5 theta. And tell me what happens. Is it the same shape?
Yeah. rotated.
But it's rotated, which makes perfectly good sense.
Because it's x.
When we graphed before, sine and cosine had the same shape, didn't they? They were just shifted. Well, now we're in a circular system, so a shift is a rotation. So you still get the same rows, it's just shifted.
Guys, you throw tan in there, something happens.
All right, let's do this.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Let's change this number now. We'll go ahead and leave it cosine. But let's change this number to a 2. Instead of a 5, let's change it to a 2. You still got a rose, but what's different about it?
It's a butterfly.
Spider. A butterfly?
Yeah, you lose a petal.
Well, how many petals does it have now?
4.
This is odd, because I bet some of you thought this guy right here, this was a 5, and that one did have 5 leaves, 5 petals?
Yeah.
But when I did this one, it doesn't have 2, it has 4. Something's going on. Let's try 3. Let's graph 3. 8 cosine 3 theta.
Why, when I'm putting tangent, it just goes crazy?
It's only as 3.
All right, let's try 4.
What do we say now? My number?
I put in 4.
4.
Okay, so let's kind of make a list here. When we graphed...
Oh, dang, dude.
When we graphed 8 cosine 5 theta, we had 5 leaves. When we graphed 8 cosine 2 theta, we had 4. When we graphed 8 cosine 3 theta, we had...
So all evens... All evens double, and all odds stay the same.
That's it exactly. When we are graphing roses, Katie Klein, this might be a piece of information you might want to know. When we are graphing roses, this number does control the number of leaves. If that number is odd, that is exactly how many leaves you'll have. So without graphing it, you can look at this equation and say, Mrs. Ford, this is a rose, and it has 7 leaves that are 8 units long. But this one is a rose that has 20 leaves that are 8 units long. All right, well, we'll continue this discussion tomorrow. Have a wonderful day. Must be like mass schedule. Hey, would you turn that off? Thank you.